ராமாய ராமபத்ராய ராமச்சந்திராய வேதசே ரகுநாதாய நாதாய சீதாயா பதயே நமஹ. So we are continuing the discussions about various topics in Ramayana, and one question that popped up is, did Shabari eat the fruits before giving to Rama? And that is not mentioned in Valmiki Ramayana. You know, Shabari was living in the ashram of her gurus. So she had seven gurus. So she was living in the ashram of her gurus, and they were extremely radiant, extremely bright sages. And usually with sages such as these, the effect of their austerities changes the environment around them. It really does change them. And people lose the idea of being violent around them. Everything is very beautiful. Everything is very sweet and all that. And the quality of the fruits and vegetables around an ashram automatically change because of the quality of the austerity of the gurus that live there, of the sages that live there. And based on this concept itself, every single fruit that surrounded Shabari's ashram was extremely sweet. So Shabari did not have to taste anything before giving it to Lord Ram. And therefore, this is not mentioned in Valmiki Ramayana. So Shabari has fruits and roots. People say that Shabari gave bear. Bear is a type of fruit, I believe. And that is not mentioned in Ramayana. Valmiki says that Shabari gave Rama and Lakshmana roots and fruits and some water to wash their hands and feet, which is just common decency. You know, that is just always given. But roots and fruits were given to Lord Ram and Lakshmana. It is not just one type of fruit. And nowhere is it mentioned that Shabari tasted the fruits beforehand and then gave them to Rama. And Rama ate second-handed fruit. It is not mentioned in Valmiki Ramayana. However, I have read that in Padma Purana, this one is alluded to. In Padma Purana, It is alluded to that Shabari ate the fruits beforehand and then Rama ate them. There are many people who give huge talks about this, how Rama ate second-handed fruits from Shabari. But, you know, let us talk about the qualities of Lord Rama that are mentioned in Valmiki Ramayana. Because, trust me, there are innumerable qualities that are mentioned in Valmiki Ramayana. Innumerable qualities. Every action that he takes has multiple meanings and multiple reasons behind them. And you know, the way he talks to his devotees, the way he behaves with them is so beautiful that we can spend lifetimes analyzing them and we can still not understand how someone can be so sweet as Rama. And therefore, we need not go through other stories. We need not really do that. If people want to follow Padma Puran, you know, it's a joy to them. But you know, as a Valmiki Ramayana follower, I just have to say that the fact that Shabari ate the fruits beforehand is not mentioned in Valmiki Ramayana. Thank you. Hari Bol.